Promise keepers at its height in the 90s lost the idea that Jesus is the promise keeper, not us. We're the promise reapers. And it got to a bunch of guys standing around in a stadium promising each other we're going to try harder. And that just leads to guilt and all kinds of nonsense. We need repentance and understand that the Holy Spirit will turn us, change us from the inside out. He'll change our desires. If you have a problem with lust, how you get rid of your problem with lust? Be filled with the Holy Spirit. Deny yourself daily. His presence will overcome you, and you'll see women in a different light. You'll see them as your equals, as human beings, instead of sexual objects. So that's the first thing, is that we remember Jesus is the promise keeper. The second thing is, promise keepers went down because there wasn't discipleship. Discipleship is the church's job, the greater church, but we're going to have a way for men when they leave that stadium, because they're going to go, and the thing you hear from guys everywhere is the feeling of hearing 80,000 men singing Amazing Grace. I've had men in tears tell me that they've never been able to recreate that feeling of the Lord and that feeling of I'm not alone. Because when there's just men together and there's no women around, they take off their little macho mask and they're vulnerable. And so many younger men have told me that their dads, that they went with their dad to Promise Keepers, and that's when he first told them that he loved them. That's when they saw their dad truly real and authentic for the first time, and it transformed them as who they are. So the first part is we want to remember who the Promise Keeper is. The second part is we want to have discipleship. So we've developed a plan, it's too much to go into now, but a way for churches to take what we've done and put men together into teams, have relationships, and to be discipled. And so those two things are really what we're after. Men who are being discipled in the Lord's word, and men who understand it's not us, it's Him.